Both these teams have had 5 days off and they'll be itching to take to the field. The Dutch desperate to keep that momentum up from that 7-0 victory over Korea. China itching to make amends for that performance against Italy. All smiles for Xu, the China captain, on the right of screen. Dirk van den Heuvel will lead out the Dutch. The Dutch are in such a rich vein of form over the last 12, 13 months in major international tournaments. They won the Hockey World League semi-final, scoring 24 goals, conceding one. They won the European Championship, scoring 18 goals, conceding one. And they won the Hockey World League final in Auckland, scoring 18, conceding none. 60 goals, 2 conceded coming into this one. And they opened their campaign with a 7-0 demolition of Korea. China, well, second in the Asia Cup for 2017, second in the Asian Champions Trophy in 2016. They lost 3-0 to Italy on day one. Okay, let's have the national anthems of both teams. Accuse the Dutch of being uptight and anxious about this one, or maybe it's just nervous laughter, who knows. But the national anthem's done and dusted. Dirkse van den Heuvel leads her side down the China line, and well, let's have a look at the two sides, starting with China Zhao in goal, then Xu, He and Chun as a back four, a midfield four of Peng, Go, Li, Wu and Wan, and a front two of Song and Chang. And there are the substitutes. The replacements will be coming thick and fast. Wienendahl starts her first game of this tournament, taking over from Connick, who played it in the first game. Kolen, Bamasaka, Stam are back three. And how about this for a midfield five? Devard, Ketels, van den Heuvel, Nunnik and De Hoda. And a top two of Van Marle and Jonker. The protege, Matlin, number 15, starts on the bench, as does the 2015 FIH player of the year, led by Belton, at number 12. Well, the Dutch haven't conceded a goal against China since the Champions Trophy in 2014. In fact, they've only conceded 2 goals in the last 10 years. Wienendahl made her debut on this pitch at Euro 2015 against Poland. And as for China, she looks fairly relaxed as well. As for China, only 4 of them come into this tournament with over 100 caps. Their last victory over the Dutch, Champions Trophy in 2003 in Australia, Sydney. They won by a goal to nil. The rain continues to fall. The clock ticks to 10 seconds to go. The crowd will count them down, and the Dutch will get this game underway. So it's Holland that's attacked the goal to our right-hand side in the chain strip of a dark graphite grey with the orange stripes down the side. China in all red. Delighted to say that alongside me, it's Mel Clulo. And Mel, on paper, this is the Dutch, is the Holland's game. As the ball comes in, it's cleared by the keeper. And it's been lost by De Waard. And it's a free hit to China. On paper, it's obviously Holland's to lose, but we've had plenty of surprises in this tournament already. One today.
Based on what we saw in the opening games for both these sides, simply the answer is no. I think the Dutch really put a marker down in that first game. And China really disappointed against a well-organised Italian side. And as you said at the start, both teams have had 5 days off, so it's almost the tournament starting again for both sides.
Number four, Van Marla. Getting the canoe run. Stick across the body, paddling away down the park. Taken by Wong, and it's a turnover ball in, no, and Marla going hunting. Ball back inside from Liu, and here is De Waard, but De Waard's pass to Marla is too soft. And China clear on the reverse, that's some take, and now the two-on-two situation, a three-on-two situation for China. And here is Gore, well tackled. Good. In the end by Colin. Van den Heuvel drops it back. Mel, your thoughts on, if you're a coach, your thoughts on that midfield five for Holland?
Well, when we saw it first come out, we were commenting, weren't we, on absolute world-class across the line. And then, as you said, when you've got Velton to come on and Matla to come on up front, Alison Annan was honest coming into this tournament that she's got an absolute wealth of talent in Holland to choose from.
Yeah, I was talking to fellow Dutch commentator before the game, and he was saying literally every year there's five or six under 21 players that could theoretically get into this squad. I mean, it's just terrifying how many good players keep coming through this Dutch system.
Yeah, I think we've spoken about a lot about the conveyor belt that they've got going on, and I think, you know, when you're the number one ranked team in the world and you're an up-and-coming hockey player, you want to play in the Dutch national side, so it's fantastic that they're also spending time developing the junior players.
Well, that's thunder you're hearing, but here come China, ball into the circle. Dirk van der Hervel's there, and Van der Hervel has to be sure, but this is good signs from China. We've talked Holland up a lot. China started very nicely.
Yeah, I think Jamelon Mulders, he was honest, wasn't he, his assessment of that first game, and you could see from his body language he's not one to shy away from showing his emotions, and you could see the disappointment right from quarter time to the end of the game. And it's very rarely that a side that he coaches can have two bad performances in a row, so it certainly will be interesting to see how he sets them up to play against this Dutch side.
16. Shit. He'll be taken. Marsaka, more thunder.
Ayana, I'm too high.
Okay, I see you.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Stormy evening here in London after what the press have been calling Furnace Friday. And, not too heavy rainstorms, too many heavy rainstorms anticipated, certainly for the first half of this one. Ball deflected into the midfield. Dirk van der Hervel surely takes the stick. Yes, she does. Out to this left-hand side, and this is Liu. Comes inside, there's a little look up, and it's luring shadows. Trying to drop it out to Liu. Looking at the edge of the circle, but the Dutch get it clear through Golan. Van Marla to Luring. No, it's not to Luring. Dropped out by Gu.
I think what disappointed me the most in the first game China had played against Italy was their basic skills were really poor. And it's not really something you associate with a Chinese side. already you can see that there seems to be a little bit more intensity with them moving the ball around the back, as well as players having the ability to pick up the bouncing ball. And I think when China do that, they can be very effective.
Now the Asian Games starts on the 18th of August, and that is a direct qualifier for Tokyo 2020. The winner gets to go, and perhaps maybe the likes of Korea, China, India, Japan, as here comes Veltins, Ludovic Veltins showing her skill. Veltins pulls the trigger across the face of goal. The Ludovic Veltins with an immediate impact.
Yeah, she robs the Chinese defence here, and it's just little movements of the ball, not very far at all, but it's the speed at which she's able to execute those skills. She's definitely going to be disappointed she's not put that shot on target, and Fredrik Mattila on the back there perhaps had her feet a little bit planted, wasn't anticipating Veltins missing the target.
Mattila. Goal scoring machine. Here is Veltins once again. Got to be careful not to use her body illegally. Up off the stick and leg of Pung. Penalty corner number one. Had four in their opening match against Korea, converted none.
Big flat stick from China's number 10, Pung, and Veltins got the skill sets. If you put a flat stick, she can either go over the top with her little lifted skills, or she can put the ball on the foot. So first penalty corner for Holland, and they really have some world-class options at the top there.
Well, number 13 is Caravan Marsaka. She's to the right of the two. And the left is Nassim. And it goes to Van Marsaka. Van Marsaka with a drag flick, and it's in. I think the keeper might have got a stick to it, but it's bounced up and into the net. It didn't hit the backboard. It might have taken a deflection. Oh, yeah. But either way, China nil, Holland one.
I think Van Marsaka may have been looking for Margot van Geffen, the player just on the penalty spot. She's got acres in there, Margot van Geffen, but Kaya van Marsaka does what she does best.
Right, it's a bouncer, isn't it?
Potentially difficult for the goalkeeper as the ball is bouncing, but just the start that the Dutch would have wanted.
I think any side that comes up against Holland would want to keep them goalless for the first quarter at least. Just gives you a little bit of an opportunity to get a foothold in the game. As it is, the Dutch have the lead 7 minutes in. They scored after, 20 seconds against Korea. The second fastest goal in World Cup history. The fastest belongs to Kim Jong-un of Korea, who scored after 14 seconds against England in 2010 in Rosario.
But interestingly, out of the seven goals that Holland scored the other night, they didn't score from a penalty corner, so they're, in this game, one from one so far.
In fact, that 7-0 defeat for Korea was Korea's heaviest ever World Cup defeat. The record defeat, 10-1, Germany against Nigeria back in the 70s. Phoenix with the stretch. On the reverse stick, that's going to be called for dangerous. Marsaka all the way across to Stam now on this near side. Van der Nassen. A diagonal ball picked up by Van Geffen. Van Geffen into the head of the circle on the reverse stick. And the shot is lifted by Mattila. And it hit De Hoda.
Ball in from Van Geffen, and I think Mattler's obviously going to be disappointed. The first two goals that she scored in the tournament were tap-ins on that far post, but she knows that she's a better player than that. Possibly got caught just slightly flat-footed, feet square, as she tried to then take the reverse stick shot.
25 goals in 40 caps for Mattler. Some record that.
I think we spend a lot of time focusing on rightly the strikers' goal scoring ratios, but actually when you watch the Dutch team defense and the work rate that the forward line actually put in, really does go to show that the first line of defence is that forward line. They harry, they harass, they win a lot of ball quite high up the pitch and are able to counter-attack from really good areas on the pitch.
There's Wu. To Xu, the captain. Xu playing it over the top. What a ball from Xu. Perfect weight landing on the stick of He. Here is Wu. Wu looking for the diagonal ball. Curtis van den Hervel. And into the body of Xu. And perhaps a little lucky the Dutch captain knocked the ball away. There's Ayana McLean of Trinidad and Tobago. And at the other end, it's Emi Yamada of Japan. Mulder's 5 years, well, he was 10 years with the Dutch Hockey Federation, five of them as head coach of the women's side. At his first international tournament as the head of the China women's team in Auckland at the Hockey World League final. And, difficulty here for Lurink, long corner. Wong. This is Song. Song still battling away. Free hit for China. Song will take. And good defending from Fenix. And off the China stick. Sideline ball, which Stam will take. Stam throws the aerial ball into midfield. Definitely brought down by Devard. Devard Jonker, oh, she left it. Moving at pace was Ketels on the outside. She wasn't to know or didn't hear the call. Wong. Still going Wong past Stam. Here is Gu. Infield to Liu. This is much, much better from China already, isn't it?
Yeah, I think this is possibly an area that Yamela Mulders has brought into the Chinese game.
Shot comes in from Gu, and somewhat hooked. Jonker. Takes it out. More rain falling now.
It's not very often that you, or historically, you don't often see Chinese teams prepared to keep the ball, rotating the ball around the back, waiting for the opportunities to open up. They're a side that likes to get the ball on into a channel and then that's where they keep it. So already you can almost see that sort of European style coming into the Chinese game.
Triple protection there, poncho, cap, umbrella. Oh, into the contact, Jonker picks up, fires it in, looking for the touch from Van Marla. It's a long corner. Van Marla scored two against Korea the other day. Very lucky. Running. Good defence from China. With the agricultural tackle.
It must be a coach's nightmare when a player does that. The Chinese defenders are in their bottom left-hand corner about 5 yards from the baseline, and a striker so keen to win the ball. Stick tackle, easy free hit. Thanks very much.
Onto the stick of Van Marla. Easy pickings for the Dutch number four, taken by Dirkse van den Hervel. Lunning trying to find Van Marla. That was a really important cutout from Bonk. Devard coming inside. Devard, lovely 3D skills. And Devard still going up off the China stick. Play on, shot comes in, penalty corner. How about that for 3D skills from Zandervaard? Good save though.
Absolutely insane, isn't it? Runs off the ball, gets the ball from Dirkse van der Hervel, and just the speed and quickness and one-handed ball up into the air. Kelly Jonker with the final touch. good save by Jurs Jon in goal. Second corner for Holland, and they've got exactly the same specialists on top of the circle with Kaya van Marsaker on the right.
Verna Nassim just behind her. Same colour shoes, same colour stick. Van Marsaker just a little bit bigger. And it comes to Van Marsaker once more. Drag flick, number one runner does a job. And that is he. Xiangjin. It comes, it's in. Long corner, didn't get the touch. Marsaker, Keitels, too much space for Keitels, up off the stick of Chun, long corner. Keitels, and Marsaker fires it in, deflection, what a goal, Jonker makes it 2-0. Unstoppable. There's absolutely nothing you can do as a keeper. Those deflections so close to you, it either hits you or it goes in. And sadly for Jur, it's got in, but delight for the Dutch. Brilliantly worked. Too much space down the middle of the park.
It's a simple crash ball in there, isn't it, by Van Marsaker? But it's the lead by Kelly Jonker. 4 or 5 yards maximum. She knows exactly where the delivery is going to come in. It's flat, it's in pace. Once you're in front of that China defender, there was, for me, only one outcome, really, and that was Jonker to score the second goal of the game for Holland.
Goal number 58 in her international career for Kelly Jonker. And that coming in the final minute of the quarter. Still got 50-odd seconds remaining. So a chance, perhaps, for the Dutch to get another one, or even China to get one back. Van Geffen off the leg. That's going to be a free hit to the Dutch. Just coming up off by Marsaker's slap.
I think China will certainly be asking the question where the player was on the line. Ball to goal. As you said, it was just hit straight down the middle of the circle, and Holland found themselves 2 versus 2.
Deflected into the middle, and it falls kindly for China. Here is Liu. Liu into the circle, and it's cleared. And that will be that. And the Dutch will get to quarter time in front. There is the quarter time hooter, and a brace of goals for the defending champions in the first 15 minutes. The first from a penalty corner, Carvan Marsaker finding the bottom right-hand corner, and then Kelly Jonker with a brilliant deflection. Quarter time score, China 0, Netherlands 2. Well, it's raining quite hard, but it's not cold by any stretch of the imagination. Here are the goals, Mel.
Fantastic by Kaya van Marsaker. Didn't manage to score one in the first game, but I think this is her favoured side. She's tall, she's able to get low. China run a 3-1 defence, so they're blocking the one side of the goal, but she's so good that she can put it anywhere she wants. And this is just a big hit down straight down the middle of the... I mean, look at that. It's wide open. There's no spare player on the line to goal. Simple delivery, and Kelly Jonker, 2 or 3 yards, waits for that delivery, deflects the ball with 50 seconds left before quarter time.
So the Dutch, even if they win here tonight, still aren't guaranteed top spot in Pool A. But it would be a brave person to bet against them finishing top of the pool. Mulders. Fascinating interview with him. That's a big piece of lightning that's just come down over in the southeastern corner of the ground. The interesting interview with Jan Mulders is saying, oh, well, talk about that in a second. Krista, who have you got?
I've got Jamie with me. A good start. You guys were up in the attacking circle a fair few times. Unfortunately, you conceded a couple of goals. Playing half court, talk me through it.
It's nice that we get compliments, but we didn't receive so many goals in the first half. So no, but we did good. Eh? The girls defended well. They start creating their own chances. we did two mistakes. They directly executed twice. That's why they were number one. But we keep on going. It's I think it's a far better play than against Italy.
Great. Best of luck, thanks.
As always, honest and spot on. They're in trouble here. And the rain is really starting to hammer down now. Phoenix to the circle edge. And, well, there'll be some damp folk in the crowd. Got another 20 minutes of this, apparently. Great new weather app. The sound engineer's just giving me credit, Martin, for that one. Out to the left-hand side. And it's up the line.
I think it's going to be interesting to see how the pitch now plays. Players were complaining about it being sticky and potentially being quite slow.
Well, now it is water-based. Now, will we get any surface water, I wonder? It drains pretty quickly, this pitch. Recently laid. Oh, dearie me. You better drink that quick. There's an opportunity for Van Geffen. Van Geffen drives the line, pulls it back. There's a shot! And it's saved for the shot from Matla. Somehow the keeper's got the right pad to it. Well, shot comes in. And another shot, another save. She's set. Well, Yo is up to the task. Here goes Velten. Velten along the line. Long corner. And an Anderson. Into the Hoda. The Hoda still going. And there's another fine save. She doesn't look too bothered about it, does she?
No, she doesn't, but again, it's the skill level, isn't it? It's just the ball is bouncing. Nice little lifted skills, and Hoda just put something at goal, making Zhuring in the China goal make a save.
The Hoda. Nandavard just let it go. Nandavard has it. And here is Golan. Geffen, that's credit to just the drainage on the pitch that he still haven't got any surface water. Look at the conditions. That's number one camera position, doesn't really do it justice. Is absolutely hammering it down as it's picked up by De Vaart. Zander Vaart goes along the line. It's picked up by Van Geffen on the shot. And folks, it's Lurink on the reverse stick shot. And yeah, with the save. Another shot comes in. That's nailed Matler, I think.
I think it's why, again, why Holland are actually so good is that they keep the ball short anyway, as we see this effort coming in.
Well, Matler gets out of the way and it hits two. And the umpires have seen enough. They're going to give them a rest with 11:15 remaining in the quarter. The players Emi Yamada and Ayanna McLean take the players off the park. And, well, no real surprise. Absolutely teaming it down. And, it's about 15 minutes or so, I believe, of intensity at this level. It's a very dark evening now. Anything will do. Player safety is the reason they've taken them off. Yeah, better off without the plastic bag, I think. It continues to hammer down. We can pick the bones out the first quarter and three and a bit minutes. I think we can hand back to Chris and the guys in the studio and get their thoughts on this one.
And I'm here with Tammy Stanley, who is the technical delegate. Can you just talk us through what's happened and why the guys have come off the pitch?
Yeah, certainly. We've been keeping an eye on the weather as it's been coming through today. And with the lightning that's come through and the rain, just due to the inclement weather with the FIH inclement weather policy, we've just temporarily suspended the match until the weather passes over. And then hopefully we'll be able to get going again as soon as possible.
Thank you so much for your time.
Not a problem. Thank you.
I am. I'm with Alison.
Waiting for official word on our play goal. Here. Of course, we're
Thanks, Chris. Yeah, all dry here in the commentary box. A few drips here and there, but everything's okay. Kit's being moved around. And yeah, we're all good to go, as are the players. And as they come back out, a little bit of lightning in that southeast corner, but not too much of a delay in proceedings. It's going to be a China ball. The captain, Xu Xia, is going to take it. And we are back underway. Remember? China 0, Netherlands 2. The players off for just under 22 minutes, and reliably informed. And we talked about the tournament's almost starting again because it'd been 5 days off for these two between games one and games two. Well, the game's almost restarted afresh. Just China have got to have given the world number ones a two-goal advantage. Penix drops it out. And Marsaka. Space for her to come forward, and they drop off to a half-court press, and still she comes. Stam into Nunnink. Nunnink twisting, turning, little head up, plays it into Jonker, who wins the free hit. Stam and Marsaka. Left-hand side. Oh, De Hoda in acres of space, trying to fire the ball into the circle. Gets the second bite of the cherry. That one was lifted in, was it? No, continued on. De Hoda cuts back inside, and the tackle's made by Gu. Gadels tries to knock it across, but China stop it at the first line of defence. First one down the line, or first time ball down the line, straight out of place. Down with the sideline ball, De Hoda.
Like the fact that China are playing more purposefully than they did against Italy. Prime example there, free hit one, taken immediately with the self-pass, and again.
Xu, who's taking it, she's the captain.
Just not giving the Dutch the opportunity to set the press.
Xu. She took that on the stick, did she, Jonker? Rather than the body. And there's Felix. Jonker head up, the top of the circle. So bouncing around in Lurink, can't get a stick on it. Here by Chun. Here is Chun. Chun up against De Hoda. De Hoda gives away the free hit, and Chun takes a rest. Justin turning into Kalen. Fenix. Blow the whistle from the plane. Feng Yang. Finds herself with a bit of a cul-de-sac, but does nicely against Fenix. Gets the ball across, the Foda's there. Long corner. Wanting is Wu. Wu gets just pace on the ball, let her down. Here goes Lurink. To Veltins, leader by Veltins, has Nunnink to her right if she wants, tries to find Nunnink for the pass from Veltins, not on target, quickly taken on the reverse stick, bouncing around, she needs to get there quickly, does, yeah, it's still there, open goal, back stick was it, Lurink puts it in, and it's 3-0, scrambling, one way and then the other, and Lorraine Lurink gets her first of the tournament.
That lead run initially distracts. Kaitors does really well here, and so many times you see players in that situation trying to score themselves. But Kaitors just moves the ball away from the goalkeeper, gets her head up, finds Lurink, who is in absolute acres of space, and she's obviously never going to miss from there. But it's the simplicity of the goal. For me, they always look to pass to the person who's in the best position.
I'm trying to give possession away here, and they could be in even more trouble. Shot comes in. Penalty corner on Nunink. So, could it be two in quick succession?
Just here, the way that the ball is carried by Zandervaart, she carries it in such a way that she can play the ball, push the ball directly across the goal, or she can play it off the right foot, almost on the 45, back towards the danger area in the circle.
So on the right-hand castle, it's Van den Assen. On the left-hand castle, is Van Marsakker. Van Marla to inject. Goes to Van Marsakker. Van Marsakker with the flick. Good save with the left glove. Jonker claiming that it was dangerous off the keeper. She's got to save it somewhere. Goes to Van den Hervel. Into the circle. Shot comes in off the post. Van Marla with the sweep shot comes back off the post. They hit the post, the woodwork, what, four times is it against Korea? How close is this?
Well, hits it square on, doesn't she? But again, it's just that short, sharp movement by Van Marla that makes that opportunity. Catches the Chinese defender on her heels. 2 or 3 yards of explosion from Kitty Van Marla, and another opportunity created for the Dutch.
Van Marsakker. Van den Hervel. Van den Hervel still going straight through the middle. Van den Hervel uses out, but Devard is there to pick up. The top of the circle, Matla on the reverse stick, doesn't get hold of it.
Just doesn't quite open up her body enough to get the ball across far post.
He Stan, plenty of time to pick up the Marsakker. Kaitels. Jonker in front of her on the reverse stick, looking for Matla. Rebounds to Van Geffen. Has Devard to her right. Van Geffen's going all the way. Falls to Devard. Good defence from China. Stam. 15 shots to none from the Dutch. 4:45 remaining. But it is a much better performance from China, even if they haven't had a shot yet.
Yeah, it is, and I think Yami Mulders is probably disappointed that this wasn't the performance that they put in against Italy. I think when you get the draw against the Dutch, yes, you're going to beat them every now and again, but the statistics show that China haven't beaten them for a while, so opportunity lost really for China when they played against a well-organised and well-drilled Italian side.
This one actually pits the top two seeds in Pool A against each other. The Dutch, obviously, number one in the world. China, the eighth ranked best. Korea, the ninth. Italy, 17th, the lowest. So that loss to Italy could be very crucial later on. And it looks like the China-Korea game on Sunday morning is going to be very, very important.
I think it'll be interesting to see, obviously, the next game coming, Italy versus Korea. But, you know, we've done and covered a few China-Korea games and they've been nil-nils and quite boring. So hopefully there's something riding on that game and it will force somebody to come out and play.
I have to say that China, certainly in recent international events, in the pool play, haven't really sort of turned up and then sort of come to life in the quarterfinals. As Veltins steals the ball, here's Van Marla. She's got Matla at the back post as she wants. Into the middle of the park. Matla stayed still. She was unmarked, but the ball didn't get through. Devard, flex to Van den Hervel, left by Van Geffen. Devard, Veltins. Velten chops it out to Van den Assen. Devard somehow gets through. She had no right to, and in fact she doesn't in the end, but I'll tell you what, the China defender who was two almost got caught napping, and China eventually get it clear, but it's have another go as they give the ball back to the Dutch. As I say, China in the last couple of major tournaments that we've covered them in haven't really turned up until the quarterfinals, but they can't afford to do that here, because if you finish bottom of the pool, you don't actually progress to the crossovers. Lovely pass to Hoda, trying to pick out Veltins at the back top of the circle. And at the moment, China just getting the edges to take the ball away from the Dutch stick, as Danny Kerry watches on.
I think what's really interesting, certainly the last, I think, three or four times that the Dutch have come in and attacked down that right-hand side, is they're looking for the 45 degree, the drop ball back into the China circle. So against Korea, I think they scored, what, three or four tap-ins on the far post by going, passing the ball flat across the D, whereas now they're actually looking for a drop ball.
So China now out of their own half. They've been penned back for about the last 4 or 5 minutes, haven't they? Just a chance to relieve some pressure. Cleared by Catles. Felt it. Oh, thought was that. Execution not quite right for once from Nida by Velten.
It was a good job for China in that situation, because it was a two-on-two. I would have backed Frederik Mattler and Ledevine Velten in that situation, but fortunately for China, she kicked the ball.
That would be a combination. Just before coming into this tournament, they've been involved in nearly half of all the Dutch goals this year. And there are a number of them. That could be a penalty. Corner shot comes in. Good save by Veenendaal. Where's the follow-up? Here it comes across. She makes another save. And Ahoda will get it clear. Well, sharp from Annie Veenendaal. Let's have another look at that. As Dirkse van den Heuvel brings it forward. And here's the chance. They're one-on-one with the keeper. Velten's all up. Mark scores. 4-0. Counter-attacking hockey at its very, very best. Annie Veenendaal makes a crucial save, and then within seconds, the Dutch are up the other end and making it 4-0. Leader by Velten with her second of the tournament.
Luring that puts China defence under pressure. But again, it's run to the middle of the pitch, collapse the Chinese defence in, and then Luring just passes it to Velten.
Yeah, almost gets there.
Nearly makes a save. Fair play to the goalkeeper in that situation. She wasn't far away, was she? But again, it's just the simplicity of the game. The Dutch do it so, so well. And then it never appears that they're worried who scores the goals. It's always about how many team goals.
They scored again in the final minute of a quarter. Scored with 57 seconds remaining in the first quarter. And with 20 seconds remaining in this one. Well, China have got a couple of shots, but they have created some opportunities. About the process for German and Molders and its young side. And there is the half-time hooter, and two goals in each of the first two quarters. In the second quarter, it was Lorien Luring, followed by leader by Velten. And the Dutch have doubled their advantage at the long break at half-time. China 0, the Netherlands 4. OK, I think we can get some reaction from the pitch. Krista, who have you got?
I've got Kelly Jonker, one of the scorers in the first half. A little bit disruptive with the rain. You guys cope with it, it's pretty fine.
Yeah, we've had it multiple times in other tournaments, so we know how to deal with it now. But just to stay calm and just to talk with each other what we're going to do when the game is starting again. And I think we picked it up great after the disruption.
And then it's all about more goals. You know, you guys being creative and looking to build on this for the rest of the tournament.
Yeah, we're never satisfied. So we want to score as many goals as we can. And I think we're doing a great job. And hopefully we can push it through in the second half now. The last game we didn't, so it's a good challenge for us to push it now.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much, Chris. Everyone's enjoying a bit of Hey Jude by the Beatles. And everyone just sort of drying off. Got a couple of people doing some aerobics behind us just to warm up. And everyone will be happy to see the heavy rain disappear. And the Dutch looking very relaxed, and so they should be. Two goals in that second quarter, and both of them, the keeper wasn't even in the picture. That is how well they are moving the ball. And this lady here, a World Cup winner back in 1998, and you checked, can she double up and be a World Cup winning coach? China get us underway in this second half through Yong Jing. And immediately a loose ball invites pressure on. Here goes Van Marle. Kitty Van Marle into the circle, just too far in front of it. She'll get the free hit on the end of the circle. Just felt that one on the back. Van Marle, who played for the Dutch here in London in 2012, 6 years ago today, the opening ceremony of the London 2012 Olympic Games. And, the Dutch. More of the same, really, from China, I guess, in the second half. And if they could find a goal on the end of it, it would just give them something for their hard work. Because, yes, they are 4-0 down, and I know we said it, but it is a marked improvement on the other day.
Yeah, it is, and I think it's just been a couple of lapses in concentration that have cost them goals, and that's why the Dutch are the world number ones. But, you know, we know the Chinese are here. It's a process for them. They're looking towards the Asian Games starting in under a month, so for them, of course, they want to progress as far as they can in this competition and play as many matches as they can, but we know that they're focusing on a different tournament later in the year.
Yeah, we just saw that along the bottom. Tickets still available for Saturday. And 18s for a pound as the ball comes into the circle. A chance here for Van Marle off the back foot. Good save. And it's not supposed to be as hot over the weekend.
It's Van Marle with the half chance here. Again, shot on target.
Fenix. Still going Fenix. Up into the leg of Wu Chung. Can't get that ball up in the air for her 3D skills. So Wu will take the 16. Wu weighs up the options. Dutch circle of graphite grey shirts, and again board out of play just inside the Dutch half. It's been the story of this quarter.
It's so hard when you play against the Dutch because you want to stretch the field high and wide, which is what I think China were trying to do.
De Waard to Ketels. Ketels, good save. She's made a number of good saves, has Zhao. And our team are still four down. De Waard. Looking for Van Marle. It's dropped out to Ketels. Back in from De Waard. Fenix is on this right-hand side. Fenix dispossessed. And a chance perhaps for China to break. Kanan has to leave it. Space on this right-hand side. Julie arrives on this right-hand side. He back into the middle of the park and shoot. Sit on to Wu. Gore twisting. Far she'd wanted to. Ketels wins it back. Fenix. Fenix with a little error too, but she doesn't lose possession. Fenix looking for De Waard. De Waard can't take it on. Play on. And back comes Abel van Geffen to win possession illegally. A little unlucky van Geffen. Look at the shot difference, 2 to 18.
you'd probably hazard a guess that at least 80 to 90% of those shots have been on target.
Poor pass picked up. Marla, lovely pass to Devard. Devard still going, is she? No, because doing enough is ooh. Nice work from Conan just steps in. It's a bit wild play, but trying to take it quickly to Chunk. Dahoda just absolutely picks that ball. It's like got Velcro on the end of her stick.
That's why they spend so many hours from the age of 4 and 5 and 6 on their basic skills.
Colin. Thanks. A deflection. It's quickly taken by Fenix. It's caught everybody by surprise, perhaps. Here is Luring. Luring drops it out to Dahoda. Lovely skill from Nova Dahoda. Dahoda into the circle on the reverse stick. Shoots, but doesn't get hold of it. Back sticks, in fact. Free out to China. Oh, we mentioned her World Cup victory in 98. Double Olympic and World Cup winner. She's won gold at the Hockey World League Finals, the European Championships, Olympic silver, Champions Trophy silver. China coach, Tony Mulders. Chuck. Can't keep the China attack going. Van Marsaka. Stam. And Marsaka. Dahoda. Stam. Far down to Dirkse van den Hövel. Dirkse van den Hövel runs unimposed into the circle. Still going. No tackle. What a fine goal. Leader by Veltins. But how much space do you want to give Dirkse van den Hövel? Carlin Dirkse van den Hövel must be one of the most destructive midfield players going forward. Not a tackle laid on her. And as a result, it's 5-0.
For me, that started with the ball into Ava Dahoda here, and basically it collapsed the Chinese defence in. Three or four Chinese defenders went to Dahoda. She managed to get the ball out wide, ball straight down the right-hand side to Dirkse van den Hövel.
Actually comes off the Chinese. This is going wide, and the player sticks it in, Wu Chung, but it will go down as Veltin's goal. That's going wide, and Wu puts it in. But Belton scores in the 37th minute, China 0, Netherlands 5. She's left it behind. Fenix. Belton. It's back in field. Dahoda, if she wants, in front of her. Here's Dahoda. Lovely pass. Couldn't quite get the shot away, but it might just fall for Luring. Still going. And Velten will pick up the loose ball, but it's a penalty corner. Okay. Hoda was going across to ask for a referral, but McLean gave it. Anyhow.
Possibly trying to play an advantage, but how many Chinese players did Luring have around her in the circle, and she still managed to keep the ball on the end of her stick and win her team a penalty corner?
Goal difference could be crucial in this group, in this pool. Korea lost 7-0. China already on -3. Now -8 their goal difference. Goes to Van Marsaka. Just squeezed up. Goes for the old-fashioned hit.
I always get baffled by this when you've got one of the world's best drag flickers in your team and she decides to hit it. And she scored.
Ooh, tell you what.
I think that looks closer than it was. I think from the angle we're at, but when you've got a wet stick from the rain, and the coach calls a hit when you're one of the best drag flickers. suppose you can try those things at 5-0 up, can't you?
Van den Heuvel.
Play, watch it, yes.
Shoot. Or is it out? So let's have a look at as it stands. And well, China now drop into that bottom position because of their inferior goal difference. Stam by Marsaka. London Assam on the right if she wants, but straight up the middle is Catles, who leads it, and getting a touch on it is Veltins. Or was it the defender? The keeper took no chances. Running at her own goal now is Shu, and possession turned over. Oh, Veltins at the top of the backswing, just about to unleash hell, and the whistle is blown. That is an Annan. Doesn't seem too impressive.
That's a beautiful touch by Catles, and it was Veltins that got the touch in front of the keeper. But this, Velton's eyes must have been wide open at that point. She's literally got a one-on-one with the goalkeeper because the Chinese defender was in no man's land and opted not to close down.
If it was nil all, I think they'd be a little bit angrier.
She's on a hat-trick, though.
She is on a hat-trick. Still got 21 minutes to find that third goal, though. And Marsaka, Van den Assam. Goes to Van Marsaka. This time she drag flicks. There's a good save. De Hoda picks it up. Here is Velton again. Can she get the shot away? She can, and tipped. Oh, tipped out by Catles rather than tipped in. Within a whisker of six.
Ready?
Great. Use of the backspace there by Velton. And I think Catles, I don't know how she's obviously hit the side of the stick rather than flush on it.
So, Marsaka once more. Slipped across that left-hand side, and that's great running from Punk. Linink moves out. The Hoda can't keep possession in play. Chu, the captain. Oh, pass. Throws the aerial ball looking for space, but it's straight onto the end of Kitty Van Marla, and the defender's out of position, and Van Marla can run unopposed to the edge of the circle. De Hoda, it's just behind her, and she can't bring it under control. But that's the danger. If you're not going to make your pass on the aerial to your defender, and it's cut out, you're exposed brutally at the back.
I think it was a poor pass by De Hoda there, because Holland had a 5-3 against China. Just put the ball behind Kitty Van Marla.
To beat Van den Assam. Free hit. Fired in, deflection, and away from goal. Side still going, Van Marla into the circle, spins back. Catles picks up. Catles trying to win the penalty corner. Here's Matlock. Matlock goes to ground, and Shu will clear. Cutting across the Chunk, trying to take the defender who is stabbed out of the equation.
What's
are you okay? Being spoken to. Been a change in the Dutch goal. Wienendaal's off. Josien Koning is in.
Pretty much the same as the first game, wasn't it? In half each. Just the other way around.
This is the chance for China. Penalty corner. China get their first penalty corner.
Given for that shove by Stam on Chung Cha-Chi. So first opportunity really for China in this game.
So Chung Cha-Chi to the top of the circle. Castle. And it is going to be her to take this drag flick. Well, she doesn't get hold of it. Connick leaning back a little bit as she clears with the left kicker, but it's out of harm's way for the time being. Here is Gore. Gore whipped in into the side of the goal. And the 16.
You can see as she's going through the action, the stick rides up the ball, so she's actually, in theory, topped it as she's tried to generate the power.
Shoot. Sideline ball. 2.5 remaining in quarter three. Well, the Dutch didn't score any goals in the second half against Korea. They got one in the second half here. And it was 7-0, yes. I think it was 23 minutes. Took those seven goals, ball in, a chance, good save, followed up by Yonka. And Nguyen makes another save, and she looks absolutely like she's just walking down the street.
It's just the speed of the reactions of the Dutch forwards. I think they know, the strikers know, that the shots are going to be on target, and therefore they're ready to pick the pieces up off the goalkeeper.
It's a long corner off the defender. Dirkse van den Heuvel. Got Van den Assem to her left if she wants. They're going down the right-hand side. Oh, that's almost made to Devard. Van Geffen wants the penalty corner. Doesn't get it. Hoda can't bring it down. Here's Chun. Shoot. 75 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Van Marla trying to close down. Ooh, Van Geffen getting a little feisty. There's Van den Heuvel picks up the free ball. Over to Hoda. As Yonka through the middle. Here is Yonka. The keeper's come. Brilliant play by the keeper. Excellent reading by Yurt.
Given for the obstruction, but fantastic play here by De Hoda. Her lead run was infield. Poor first touch by Kelly Yonker, I think she'd admit that. Goalkeeper's in a fantastic starting position.
Lering. Good pick on the reverse stick by Chan. Chan, though, forced back, but finds a good pass to Pung. Now, Pung with a chance to pick a pass, but she drags it. Everyone had made the run to the near post, and she went between the penalty stroke spots and the injection for the penalty corner.
I think that's just typical of the way the Dutch play, though. When you watch certainly the final quarter, is the runs are always infield to collapse the Chinese defence in.
What a lead that is. And Lurik, can she get to it? She's trying, she's got there, and there is the final hooter. So in vain for Lorraine Lurik, but she finds the amusing side net. Belton's, Alan's like, didn't you realise the clock was ticking down? Belton's adds to the scoreline. Just the one goal for the Dutch in that third quarter, China 0. Netherlands 5 now. Solana goes to work for one final time. Let's have a look at this goal again. And beautifully well worked. There's a number of times, though, for a number of the Dutch goals, where a player in graphite has been able to run unopposed in or towards the circle and pick a pass.
But I think it is clearly the connections, but I think the Dutch team here have got probably 80, 90% of their team are from three club sides out in Holland. So already those connections are there. And then it is just that fine tuning. And Frederik Mattler said the other day they spent hours and hours and hours working on their circle work. And it's just a really prime example of the fact that you don't need to be making 10, 12 yard runs across the circle. It is literally short, sharp. You wait for the ball to be delivered before you make that lead.
Yeah, he's got the tunes. He's enjoying himself. Yeah, those three clubs you talked about, Amsterdam, Den Bosch and SCHC. OK, Krista, who have you got?
I've got Alison. The outcome's pretty much determined in this game. Is it about, you know, practising the penalty corners and tactically getting yourself right for future games?
It's about finishing the game. And like I said beforehand, we wanted to play a complete game. The first quarter wasn't what we wanted, and the second and third quarter is. I think we're playing well now. So it's about finishing it off right now.
OK, let's hope you do that.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Yong gets the final quarter underway. China 0, Netherlands 5. In another accomplished performance by the defending World Cup champions. Here is Chung. And using her body to shield the ball, gives possession to the Dutch.
Something about the way the Dutch play. When the midfielders pick the ball up and they're attacking forwards, they drive towards the middle of the pitch, and then you'll see two other players getting ahead of the ball, but either side. The Chinese defence collapses in, you go around them. If the Chinese defence doesn't, then the person on the ball can keep running.
Ayana?
Yes.
We can use pick up and pull.
Yeah. Yeah. Out of play.
We need to come back, set up.
Yeah. Phoenix, forward. Lurink, not out though. Lurink will have time to pick this up, have a look around, spin back. Stam, Colin. Catles. There's the long corner. Catles driving along the baseline, still going. Catles ball across, no one in grey there. Nothing. Balls to Nunink. Nunink on the reverse stick, she get it strong, fires it across. Catles taps it up, and the keeper clears. De Hoda. That's that right hand side. Here's Phoenix. Looking for a foot, tap behind for a long. Vandenassem, Stam. Nunink, Conan. Conan with a swing and a miss. Trying to get it round the back and up that left-hand flank, and here is Gore. Gore loses out to De Hoda. Phoenix has to run and stretch for that one. Can't bring it under control. Shoot. De Hoda. So next up, we have Korea up against Italy, and the Italians arriving as well. Ball forward, lucky for Junk.
You must feel like that quarter time came at the wrong time for the Dutch. Felt that they were really going through the motions, really working on their connections, getting some shots away.
Nunink and Catles combining well. Catles back again. Mattler's in front of Catles. Here is Mattler, just overruns it, gets possession back. Can she find the shot? Trying to work it onto the back stick, fires it across the goal, and it's good defensive work by China. Lovely understanding and connection between Catles and Nunink. It's an interesting aerial throw by Tong Yang. Nanink. Stan. And Marsaka. Colin. Belton. Plays in the field to place of Evan Hervel. Back to Belton onto her foot. Almost a brilliant combination between the captain and leader by Belton.
You can certainly tell that they've played for years and years together. The link-up play, they almost instinctively know where the other one's going to be.
Fenix, lovely work. Still going, Fenix into the circle. Here she comes. Oh, and what a tackle that is by Shu, the captain. Malou Fenix about to have a go on the reverse stick. Shu. Free hit, China. Leave it.
This is partly China's problem. You can see all the players now catching up with play. So when China are getting the ball forwards or into the Dutch half, they've got limited options, and the Dutch work so hard to get numbers back behind the ball. The Chinese ball carrier really only has one option, and that is to win a free hit.
Here's Wong. And there's a long corner. Taken by Bunk. Shoot. Collected in, picked up by Nunnik, but it's a dangerous ball. Nunnik was away. Close to Van den Hervel. Looking for Van Geffen. What a pass that is. Now Van Geffen's got leader by Jonker, sorry, to her left. Van Geffen into the circle. Van Geffen fires it in and then somehow avoids the rebound by Commando rolling away. Geffen looking for a goal. Didn't score too many. 11 in 163, and now 164 caps.
Yeah, I think personally, I mean, it's a fantastic save, isn't it? To be, you know, Kelly Jonker did exceptionally well to make it onto that far post.
De Hoda. De Hoda pulls it back. Yeah, pulls it back just a little bit too far. And, well, Chung is going to have to do it the hard way, trying to pick the run of Chang. And Mahler's made a mess of that. Almost picked off. It is picked off by Wong. Wong. Three hits. And advantage. Chung. Off the stick of Marsaka. Just a little bit more pressure coming from China now. Right on the edge of the circle. And so can't keep it in play. So, but we need a player of the match off you. You're going to have 4.5 minutes until we need an answer. So, sufficient time, I'm sure, to get the thinking cap on. There's a steal high up the park by Gore. Now Gore playing it in. There's the opportunity for the shot play back inside. They want the penalty corner play on. Chung are going to refer it. Here comes Bung, and Kelly Hudson called into action for the first time.
No. Kelly?
Yes, I hear you, Amy.
China, ask for hood.
Okay, I'll look for a foot in the circle for you.
Thank you.
It took a while for this referral to come. It was a great steal up here.
Now this oh this is it here.
I don't know if there was one on Ava de Hoda as the ball was played back across. There's definitely nothing there from Stam. Just here.
Does that move? On the right, off the right foot, here you go.
Yeah, ooh, off the shin pad, I think.
Right.
Literally. Almost like the right ankle, I think.
It's not that one.
It's not, it's definitely not on Lauren Stammett earlier than that. Yeah. It's definitely on Ava de Hoda.
That's the angle. That's the angle they want to watch it at. Yeah. But it's the about 5 seconds earlier. Well, that's the free hit there. Hold on.
Well, that's going to be...
This is the angle here.
I think it brushes the almost the right ankle of Ava de Hoda here. What? Right ankle there.
All right, here we go.
Emmy, can you hear me?
Yeah.
There is no clear reason to change your decision. Restart with a free hit to the defence and China lose their referral.
Well, no. Glad to see we're where we usually are on those video referrals. No, I didn't think it had touched the foot, but it was very fine. It was. That's sharply in. Ooh, Devard was sharply in, but it goes against the Dutch player. Just under 6 minutes remaining. Can the Netherlands add to their tally? Can China find a first goal of this 2018 Hockey Women's World Cup? Now, down that left-hand side goes Wu. Wu down to the goal line. Jump across the goal, or at least trying to, cleared by Van der Nassen. Four wins the free hit. Taking it five, running onto the stick of Stam. And here is Jonker. And on her bike goes Lauren Lurink. Van Marle's up to the left-hand side if Lurink can find her. Here is Devard. Shot comes in. And it's gone between the legs. What a counter-attacking goal that is. It's gone to Kitty Van Marle. But it was a beautiful interplay between Lurink and Devard down that right-hand side. Van Marle got on the end of it, sneaked through the keeper's leg. The keeper's had a great game, to be fair to her, but on this occasion, she's nutmegged.
Going to get bored of saying it, but it's a simple game, really. Look at this, simple 1-2. Xu, the Chinese captain, is all over the place, but and she's done exceptionally well to dive and get something on that, but Van Marle first to it. You perhaps could have done a little bit better with it. It looks like her feet get slightly stuck in the turf just here.
Well, I think actually Van Marle hits down on the ball. She doesn't cleanly hit it, and it's one of those bobbly ones as a keeper. You think it's coming a lot faster than it actually is. You sort of overplay it. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's a goal either way. China 0, Netherlands 6. Goal in every quarter for the Dutch in this one. And Van Marle now has 3 in the competition. Leader by Belton. And Marsaka. Hoda. Marsaka. And Anasim loses out. Now, into the top of the circle. Chance here on the first. Oh, what a finish! That is Yong Jing with an absolute belter on the reverse stick, and they do get something for their endeavour this evening. China get their first goal of the competition, and it's worth waiting for, Mel.
Oh, that's an absolute belter, isn't it? Puts it onto that backhand. Conning flies across her goal, trying to keep that one out. You got to say, it's actually bouncing as it comes across. Superb finish by China, and you've got to say, particularly in this quarter, they've deserved something on the scoreboard. And you can see what it means to him to actually register his first goal at the World Cup.
Yeah. And they'll just lift them, won't it? China getting a score sheet, but Felton down the other end. Oh, Velton, lovely skill on the edge of the circle, but good recovery from Punk.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
28 shots to 4, not a bad conversion rate.
Let's play.
For China, pretty similar to that of the Dutch.
It's true, though, isn't it? If someone has 20 shots at goal and scores four, and it's obviously 1 in 5, we go, well, that conversion rate's not very good. But then if somebody does one, it's sort of exactly the same situation, but because they've not had as many opportunities, they're almost let off the hook.
Nice work from Chun. And she will take the free hit that she's done, and she hasn't. She's not going to leave it to Wong. Final 2.5 minutes then. China 1, Netherlands 6. Wong. First goal since 2014 for China against the Netherlands in an international tournament. Okay, Mel, next pause in proceedings. Ask you for your player of the match. Velton, lovely bit of skill. Leader by Velton, still going, skips away from yet another potential tackler. Right hand side, wouldn't you know? We're not going to get a pause in play now, are we? Javard, Matla. Matla uses her strength. She's got Dosa. There's two of them in front of them. Dosa van den Hermel, and it's a seventh. Zandervaard with the goal, but you know you're in trouble when you've got two players bearing down on your keeper. And as we've seen throughout, not a selfish bone in the Dutch players' bodies. It's all about the team effort, nothing the keeper can do about that.
But it's just the willingness of De Vaart and Dirks van der Hervel to get ahead of the ball. Matla releases the ball, nice and simple. Most players in that situation would probably have a go themselves, but Van der Hervel rolls it to her mate on the far post. They really do make the game look so, so simple.
Thank you very much. A 10th goal for Zandervaart. And Mel, I'll need your player of the match, please.
Yeah, I think obviously it's going to be one of the Dutch players. I think Dirks van der Hervel has played exceptionally well. Velton scored 2 goals.
Dancing around in the circle, there's De Vaart looking for a second, and the Dutch can't capitalise this time.
But my player of the match is the Dutch number 6, Lorien Lurink. I think she's been outstanding, set up a number of the goals, worked exceptionally hard for her team. So yeah, she's my player of the match.
Well, congratulations to her. Just having a little look around, I've got a sneaking suspicion she's on the bench. Well-deserved rest. Scored by China. Is there to be one last goal for them? No. That's going to go against Stam. It all came to life in the last 4 minutes of the quarter, didn't it? Goalless and 3 goals. As De Vaart can't get through, and I think that is going to be it inside the final seconds. The crowd countdown, high fives all round. Stam throws the aerial. There is the final hooter, and the Dutch make it two wins out of two. It's another seven goals for Colleen Dirkset van den Heuvel and her team in the third quarter. Goals for Van Marla and Devard, but China scoring the pick of the goals. Their number 17, Yong Jing, scoring. And the final score, China 1, Netherlands 7. So what does that mean for the Pool A table? And it means this: China's goal difference is now at -9. Italy and Korea are up next, and Korea can really put some distance between themselves and China with a win. And there it is, next up, 8:15 instead of the original time of 8 o'clock due to the thunderstorms we had and the 20-minute break that China and Netherlands had in the first half, just at the start of the second quarter. OK, let's get down onto the pitch and get to Krista.
And I'm down here with Kaya Matasaka. Well done on your goal, but, you know, 14 goals for the Dutch in the opening two games of the World Cup, not a bad start.
No, not a bad start at all. I think we're doing really well, and we keep passing the ball and scoring goals, so it's really nice.
Frustrated to concede that one goal that happened right at the end there?
Yeah, of course. You want to keep zero in the back in the defense, so it's a shame, but we'll look at it and make everything tighter.
And your coach alluded to having a complete performance. That's what you're looking for, and looking to the match against Italy, is that what you guys are looking to build on?
Yeah, of course. I think we're playing really well and a bit fast game, and we keep on building it, and Italy is up next.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Kaya.
Thank you.
Begonnen zo ontspannen bij jullie, bij die volksliederen. Dat was bijna jolig.
Nou, nee, zo voelde het voor ons niet hoor. En zeker, we hadden 4 rustdagen, dus iedereen had weer heel veel zin om weer een wedstrijd te gaan spelen. En ik denk dat je dat wel zag.
Ja, jullie moesten ook ergens om lachen. Weet je nog waarom?
Nee, dat was denk ik niet op mijn waar ik stond, dus dat weet ik niet.
Ja, werd jullie ritme nog een beetje doorbroken door al die regen?
Het viel wel mee. We kwamen net wel lekker erin. Maar goed, we wisten van tevoren dat die kans erin zat, dat het gewoon in de lucht wel hing, het onweer. Dus toen rustig in de kleedkamer gebleven en konden we gewoon doorspelen.
Ja, nu duurde het tot de 7 uur, toen lag jouw strafcorner erin. Ja, het leek allemaal zo makkelijk ook te lopen, hè? Maar je moet maar even die eerste erin liggen.
Ja, zeker. Het is fijn als je eerst in ligt. En sowieso, het ziet er misschien makkelijk uit, maar doordat we gewoon echt heel hard werken met elkaar en die bal laten rondgaan, krijgen we dit resultaat.
Ja, want ondanks die ontspanning die ik zag, spelen jullie ook met het hoofd. Want jullie laten af en toe die Chinese vrouwen komen en dan komen ze eruit. En dan ga je er met snelheid weer overheen bij balverlies van hun.
Ja, zeker. Nee, het is ook fijn om af en toe wat ruimte voor in te kunnen creëren. En verder is het belangrijk in de opbouw ook geduld te houden om dat ook te kunnen krijgen.
Hoe blijven jullie scherp? Want jullie moeten zo lang wachten, bijna 2 weken lang, ja, tot echt die knock-out wedstrijden eraan komen. Jullie echt onder druk al komen te staan.
Nou, ik ben nu heel erg blij dat we gewoon deze tweede wedstrijd weer hebben gespeeld. En zondag mogen we weer, dus we zitten nu helemaal goed in het ritme en dat gaan we gewoon doorzetten.
Ik snap het, maar zijn jullie met het achterhoofd al bezig met, hey, als alles loopt zoals we verwachten, dan zou Engeland wel eens de tegenstander kunnen zijn in die kwartfinale.
Ja, het zou zomaar kunnen, maar voor nu zijn we echt nog bezig met gewoon onze eigen eerste wedstrijd.
Echt waar?
Ja, nee, ja, oprecht. Tuurlijk kijk je ook de andere wedstrijden en het is heel mooi om hier te zien. Dus we gaan wel zien wat en wie we tegenkomen.
Hebben jullie eigenlijk nog iets te wensen?
Op dit moment ben ik zeker tevreden met deze wedstrijd.
Niks te wensen?
Nee, gewoon dit doorzetten.
Wordt dat moeilijk of niet?
Dat gaan we zien. Ja hoor.
Sam, Sam, ben je er nog? The other one?
Oh, we can use the same mic he's saying, yeah. Okay, mate, no problem.
Same mic?
Yeah. Okay. You want to go out that way?
That way, yeah.
Okay, he's going again on 13.
Behalve dat jullie echt een WK-wedstrijd spelen, zag ik jullie ook bijna de hele wedstrijd lachen.
Ja, ja, we hebben het naar ons zin. We pasen veel en dat is altijd leuk. Ik denk dat we het gewoon echt met z'n allen naar ons zin hebben. En ik denk dat eigenlijk dat ook wel de key is van de grote score.
Ik zag het ook al bij de volksliederen.
Ja, klopt. Ja, we hadden het erover gehad. Het is 2 keer, het is ben en blijf. En we zeiden allebei blijf, blijf. In het volkslied. En we deden het weer verkeerd en daarom moesten we lachen. Dat was het, denk ik.
Blijf, blijf?
Blijf, blijf. Nou ja, moet je maar de tekst opzoeken.
Jullie hadden het net verkeerd.
We hadden het precies verkeerd, ja.
En waren er meerdere die dat hadden?
Ja, het was in de groepsapp gestuurd, hoe het nou echt moest. Dus we waren eigenlijk allemaal gefocust dat we het deze keer wel goed zouden doen. En toen deden we het dus verkeerd en dat was denk ik de smile op ons gezicht.
Zorgt zoiets dan meteen voor uw totale ontspanning in de wedstrijd?
Ik denk dat het wel goed is om even van tevoren even nog even te lachen. En dan gaat ook gewoon de knop om en dan willen wij gewoon vlammen.
Want jullie kunnen eigenlijk, ja, toeleven naar die kwartfinale waarin het, ja, er echt om gaat. Hè? En ongetwijfeld rekenen jullie mee, net zoals wij, van nou, dat zou misschien door al die verrassingen in het toernooi wel eens Engeland te kunnen worden.
Ja, nou, we gaan het zien. Ja, we zijn er sowieso klaar voor, denk ik. En willen we wereldkampioen worden, moeten we sowieso iedereen kunnen verslaan. Dus wij zijn er klaar voor, denk ik.
Jullie spelen wel heel erg makkelijk, hè? Jullie vinden elkaar goed. En als er eens een keer niet goed gaat, hoor, dan lukt het een minuut later wel weer.
Ja, nou, we hebben gewoon afgesproken dat we met z'n allen voor elke bal vechten. Dus als we hem een keer verliezen, dan gaan we gewoon met z'n allen terug en proberen het gewoon opnieuw. En ik denk dat we dat heel goed doen.
Hebben jullie nog iets te wensen?
Misschien nog meer kansen afmaken, want we hebben er wel heel veel. En nu gaat het denken.
Wat zeg je als je er al 7 hebt gemaakt, hè?
Ja, precies. Maar we hebben er nogal meer dan dat, denk ik. En op een gegeven moment worden we een beetje laks misschien in de cirkel. En we gaan iets meer alleen. En ik denk als we dat echt nog gewoon samen kunnen doen en niet laks kunnen worden, dat het dan echt nog veel leuker kan worden.
Dus nog iets meer de concentratie behouden?
Ja, denk het wel.
En dan? Gaat dit een onvergetelijk toernooi worden?
Dat hoop ik zeker.